Now let's learn how to differentiate the composition of two functions. So we have a function y, which is a function of x, and x itself is a function of t. So if we have this type of function, we'd like to know how to take the derivative of y with respect to t. We can use the Leibniz notation with differentials so that dy dt we can write as dy dx times dx dt. And the Leibniz notation says it's okay then to cancel dx with dx because we're treating dy dx and dt as these infinitesimals that we can manipulate like fractions. So let me show you how that works with an example. So for instance, if we have y of x equals x squared, and we have x of t equals 1 plus t squared, right? Then what would y of t look like? So y gets the argument 1 plus t squared, and then y says we're supposed to square it. So y of t would be 1 plus t squared squared. Okay, but here we're going to use the Leibniz formula for the chain rule to differentiate. So we need to find dy dx. So dy dx then is the derivative of x squared, which is 2x. And we have to find dx dt. So dx dt is the derivative of 1 plus t squared, the derivative of 1, a constant is 0. The derivative of t squared is 2t. So then we have dy dt, which is dy dx, which is 2x, times dx dt, which is 2t. So we multiply these. I'll write that as 4t times x. And most of the time, we want to know this as a function of t. So at this point, we can substitute in x equals 1 plus t squared. So that would be 4t times 1 plus t squared. Okay, so that's from the Leibniz notation. Sometimes it's actually quite useful, but the main way we differentiate composition of two functions is using this formula, that if we take two functions, f of g of x, so this is a composition of f and g, and take the derivative, what we do is we take the derivative of the outside, f prime of g of x, times the derivative of the inside, g prime of x. And this is equivalent to the Leibniz formula. So we remember this as the derivative of f of g of x, or the derivative of the outside of a function of the inside, f of g of x, equals the derivative of the outside times the derivative of the inside. So how would we do that in this example? So we have our y now, rather than writing it as x of t, we just write it as a function of time, right? So the inside was 1 plus t squared. The outside was x squared. So this is a function 1 plus t squared squared. And then when we take the derivative with respect to time, so this, let's just write dy dt, going back to the Leibniz notation, is the derivative of the outside. So the outside is something squared. So the derivative of the outside is 2 times the inside. The derivative, so it's the derivative of the outside times the derivative of the inside. So the derivative of the inside is the derivative of 1 plus t squared, which is 2t. So remember this formula, this idea, to take the derivative of the composition of two functions, you take the derivative of the outside times the derivative of the inside. And if we simplify that, we get our 4t times 1 plus t squared, which is identical from the Leibniz notation method. Okay. For the polynomial, of course, we can always just expand it. Let's make sure we get the same answer. So here, if we expand 1 plus t squared squared, we would get 1 plus the cross term, which is 2t squared plus t squared squared, so plus t to the fourth. We can take the derivative then of the polynomial. So dy dt, derivative of 1 is 0. The derivative of 2t squared is 4t. The derivative of t to the fourth is 4t cubed. And then we can factor it. We have a common 4, we have a common t, and we have a 1 plus t squared. So here we got the same answer, 4t, 1 plus t squared, 4t, 1 plus t squared, 4t, 1 plus t squared. So more or less three different methods, but they're all, the first two are the chain rule in the Leibniz notation and in the functional notation, and the last one is just expanding it. Okay, so the thing to remember from this video is to take the derivative of the composition of two functions. It's the derivative of the outside times the derivative of the inside. I'm Jeff Chasnoff. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.